Good morning! It is Friday right before St. Patrick's Day. Now, I was going to start the show with a green beer. But since our guest today is talking about eating healthy, I didn't think it'd be a match. So I had to dump the beer, get the green glasses, and that's how we were going to do the show because today is going to be a good one. It is about running a business and being healthy, which I think you can drink red green beer. Well, red beer would be Christmas. Right now, green beer. So let me tell you a little bit about my guests today. So, of course, we have the sensational Nancy Seeger, who is our national corporate sponsor, and she takes care of all your business headaches. And then we have Michelle Post. And she is going to share some great knowledge with us about running a business and being healthy. So I'm going to start with Nancy and see what the heck is going on with Madame Nancy Seeger this week. And she's
Hey,
coming. There you are. Hello, Nancy. How are you?
awesome. How are you this morning, Bridget?
I'm good. I'm good. So what's new in your world?
What's
Hey,
new?
what happened to Facebook this week? Do you
Oh,
know?
there's going to be a few weeks before all the real answers come out, but there was problems in their back-end server systems, and they are saying only 12,000 people were affected worldwide, and I don't think that's anywhere close to the numbers.
Oh my God, my favorite that I saw was on Twitter, somebody declaring themselves safe from the
Something.
Facebook outage. That was false. And I thought, oh my God, that's hysterical. But you know what? Yeah, it's funny and we had fun, but it's serious business. Like it affected my business
Well, and I
because I
would.
had two events and we couldn't talk and invite people and post. It was serious.
It was serious, and you know what? You know this, Bridget, I preach it all the time. If your business is totally dependent on Facebook, you have no control over what's going to happen. And so you do need the email list. You do need another way of taking your contacts and moving them into a conversation outside of something so that you can control it, so that you have that access. Because there, if Facebook had been down for a week, with Women Talk and all the events going on, that would have been catastrophic for that attendance.
Yeah.
So it is so critical to understand the tools and to know that even the biggest and the best, you probably don't remember this, but a couple of years ago, Amazon did a server switch where they were upgrading some systems on their back end. And now corporations, major corporations, depend on Amazon to run their back end businesses and everything else. And even Amazon, the absolute, mammoth out there, they shut down some businesses for up to a month. A
Oh, that's
month.
insane. Like that could put somebody out of business.
It could. And it
Yeah.
really damaged Amazon stock because you can't have those kind. And it was literally a typo in a command line that they were changing servers. And there's so much code there, it took them a month to get everybody back online. They found the problem within 48 hours, but to roll it out and put people back online took almost a month.
Nancy? That's why I don't do coding. Because I would actually have to use alcohol, drugs. Like to be able to go through all of this would just be a nightmare.
Well, that's why you
But
got to know your systems and you got to have redundancy built in. You got to know another method of keeping in touch with your contacts.
I know. And you know, the whole time we were trying to do this, I was thinking about you and these words that you keep saying all the time. Email, 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 baby. You must capture every single one of your customers' email. And then I think that you have to do more than just capture it because if you never talk to them on email, then they won't expect it. Like you need to use email.
You need to use every tool you can to build relationships. 99.99% of us will have an email address that we can always respond to. There's also a percentage that will give you a cell phone number so you can send text messages if there's something up with your email. There's so many options, but it really has to be a completely well thought out strategy so that you do not miss all of the important ways to build relationships with your clients. But yes, email has to be first and number one. It is the best way. if you're using it properly to build relationships with your contacts.
Yeah. So that was a great lesson for everyone this week again. So if you follow Women Talk or Nancy, we actually are going to be doing more of this. We're going to be putting workshops to teach you how to use email properly. And that will also give you an idea that maybe you do need to hire somebody, because yes, it will cost you money, maybe like $100 a month or whatever, but then it could actually literally save your business.
Totally, totally true. It is an investment. It is not an expense. And it is about how you want to grow your business and how quickly you want to grow your business. Because there's only so many hours in a day. And as you found, Bridget, growing your business, there's a point in time where you reach where you're just stuck until you change the systems. So, you know, in an opportune situation, you get that all in place ahead of time. And you grow your business with it, and if that system scales with you, you will not ever reach that kind of a block in growing your business.
Yeah, and I must tell you, one of the things about me is I've been collecting emails since 1999. I think that should be the title of a song, because it's so good. But I've been collecting emails since 1999, but it's not good enough to just collect emails. You got to have systems. Which is what you're teaching me, and I will forever be grateful. So thank you for everything you do. Now that we, you know, we're talking business and all that, let's bring on board Michelle, because we want to talk about having the energy to do all this crazy work that running a business takes, because believe me, you need a lot of energy to be an entrepreneur. Hello, Michelle Post.
Hello, Bridget. Hello, Nancy.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good. So why don't you tell me a little bit about you and what you do, other than the fact that you have been a Women Talk member, so you have been speaking, and you have just joined the sisterhood as a director at Calgary South.
I'm so super excited to be part of the movement that you've visioned here, and to move it out there, because I just really believe that our stories matter, and you know, it just boils down right even back to health. You know, because we do store our emotions inside of our body. And if we don't get them out, then they just sit there and they can rot and they can create more illness. So even on the health aspect, just sharing your story for your own personal sake is amazing. Absolutely amazing to just get it out. And in the platform that you've also made, no shame, no guilt. You're completely supported. Everyone is open to whatever your story is, whether they experienced it for themselves or not. So I can't say how much I absolutely love being part of it. So thank you. Thank you very much.
So welcome. So tell me, what do you do for people?
So
what would I come and see you for? Other than belly dancing.
Right. Tomorrow night. That's the big show. So So for people who actually are having health issues that actually want to move forward, and if they have medical care, that's absolutely great. But I actually work with nutrition and how nutrition actually can impact the body. So that's the different components of different foods, and every single person is biologically different. So we all require different nutrients inside of our body. So I actually put those nutrients together for you based on your own blood work, believe it or not, and help reset your metabolism and rebalance hormones.
So what do you mean your own blood work? What does that mean? Do you actually take blood from me?
I don't personally do it. I do have a doctor's requisition under the program that I use called Metabolic Balance. And so for people who hire me for the duration there, they actually will go and get a blood work done. And then we'll input that. In Germany, actually, they have nutritional doctors there that I work with. And so they'll put together the exact foods for each individual that they need to eat in order to increase their metabolism, rebalance hormones, and amazingly feel better. Like,
amazing. Oh, that's kind of interesting.
It's probably the best program that I've researched so far when it's come to doing holistic nutrition, and it's super empowered me. I have a history of Crohn's disease. So in and of itself, I've done keto-like GAPS programs. I've done other programs, SIBO programs, FODMAPs, all kinds of stuff. And nothing has actually helped me with the Crohn's-like symptoms. And so when I did this one, even though it was for, I did it for weight release, like seriously, I have never had the same issues that I've had my entire life, like since I was 20 years old. So,
oh, that's kind of interesting.
Yeah. So
very interesting. So do you just design a diet, like a diet plan for people, or do you do other things?
Fine. So yeah, so that's actually part of it. So there's menu programming. It's mostly a lifestyle change that people have to do. Our North American society has the most whack lifestyle when it comes to food. We think we're starving, but yet I can reach over here and grab something and eat it. You know, like we are not starving. And it's really important to actually teach my clients what the difference is between true hunger and habits. We've been so habitualized to eat on a regular basis. And believe it or not, that's actually keeping us legged down with our energy. You know, our digestive system takes 40% of our energy just to repair itself on a minute by minute basis. So if we actually ruin it, then it needs more and we can get really tired.
What's the absolute worst food to eat?
Oh, well,
if you had to pick one that I need to take it out of my diet.
Sugar.
Yeah.
Sugar, sugar, sugar. It is so addictive. It is inflammatory. It just creates so much chaos with our hormones, and it's not necessary. There's so much sweet regular sugar in regular whole foods. It's just not necessary to add any other refined sugars into our diet whatsoever. And they're everywhere.
I know, it's crazy. I used to own a gym. Excuse me. I used to own a gym, Curves. And of course we did a lot of training and we got into the food. And I remember when I started learning about food, what absolutely shocked me was that you would go and buy a diet salad dressing because you want to lower your calorie intake. And once you start reading the label, that you see that they replace fat, it's sometimes good fat, with sugar.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And there's no direct correlation with healthy fats and obesity. There's no correlation. The only fats would be trans fats, so fried foods, hydrogenated fats. You still need a good conglomeration of saturated and unsaturated. You need the whole gambit, just not those ones. So they replace the good fats that your body requires because fat tastes good. You remember Pulp Fiction? Fat tastes good. Pork tastes good. You know, like, there's a reason for this.
I think you should break into a song just right now. Right? Do it again. Come on, go for it.
Tastes good. Pork tastes good. Food tastes good. I like food. Actually, I love food.
Love it. Woo woo. What about green beer? Okay. What's your opinion on green beer?
Well, I'm going to have some after the show tomorrow night. So. I love to live by the 80-20 rule because the majority of people out there, they really are addicted to the sugar lifestyle. So, you know, let's be reasonable in our society. Let's be reasonable. So once we've actually had the right foods and our health, our body is back into regular balance, there's no reason why you can't go out there and enjoy a green beer on St. Patrick's Day. You know, your body, you have the tools, you have the lifestyle to combat that moving forward. You know the repercussions of what it does to your own body, so you can accommodate. So even though you've heard me, I rarely drink, and not because I don't want to, it's because I can't handle it anymore.
I know. Is it something that happens to your body when you like hit or get close to 50? Because all of a sudden wine just made me feel awful.
Right.
And red wine, and it never used to. And now some of my red beer, not the dark one, but the amber beer seem to really affect me negatively as well. Like, what the hell is that all about?
We have so much inflammation already in our bodies that it actually creates more inflammation. And of course, where does your migraines or your headaches or your hangovers come from, right? Like you need that excess water to move through the system. So yeah, we've just accumulated it. So it's best to keep our bodies nice and clean to the best of our ability so that we can go out and enjoy an evening next weekend. So.
So, what do you do for fitness?
Oh, it's fun. I hate winter. So it's really difficult, you know, for me to get out. I love to walk in the summertime. We have a nice, beautiful pond. So I do a lot of walking. I have taken up jogging. When I actually, believe it or not, quit smoking many years ago. I was not always good to my body. So I have a lot of cleanup still to do for the rest of my life. So jogging was really good for me. Not necessarily the best. I also have a weight room downstairs. We converted the basement into a nice little gym. We have an elliptical, a Bowflex. So, and then of course, belly dancing. That's my favorite exercise. So
I was waiting for that one to come up.
Right, you know, it's what I'm doing tomorrow. So,
and I think you bring up a very important point, right? Is that, which actually kind of relate to running a business as well, is that you must find your groove, you know, if you don't like jogging, then don't force yourself jogging because you're not going to enjoy it and you're not going to stick with it.
Nope.
And same thing with business sometimes, you know, there's things that, I mean, when you first start, sometimes you have to, but bring the people on board that will do the stuff that you don't like doing so that you can do what you're good at.
Yep, absolutely. You have to love the exercise that you do. Well, you have to be able to tolerate it and then learn to love it. So
that's a better way to put it, I think.
But sometimes I think that you do love it. Like I played hockey for 25 years. And I mean, and I played ball hockey and soccer and tennis. You put any object in front of me that I have to take away from other people, and I'm on it, baby. And I can play for hours and hours and hours. But you make me jog. It's like, yeah. I'm half a block and I think I'm dying. And I'm like, what the hell?
Oh, it was tough when I quit smoking. I could jog for about a minute and a half. Mm-hmm. And I was keeling over and I just kept at it. Right. And then finally, I think about 6 months later, I was able to jog for 7 minutes and I got a runner's high off of 7 minutes.
Oh, that's funny. I find jogging is a real mental thing for some people. For me, it is like, cause my brain is so loud and it just start yakety yak and even walking. So you know what I started doing, and I can't run because I've had 4 knee surgeries and my knees are a mess, but I can walk and I find like listening to my audiobooks.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden it's like I've been walking for an hour and I don't even know it.
Yeah, that's brilliant because definitely I think listening to things, like you said, when I jog, I have to have some hard pounding music, you know, some, I'm a rock and roller through and through. And when I walk, I do investing courses. I do all kinds of courses that I take, right? And those are the times that I can do it. So, you know, I get to be efficient at the same time. So,
yeah. What do you do, Nancy?
Oh, so you guys know, I have the miracle morning thing that I'm all about. So I always start with meditation and breathing exercises, deep breathing especially. And then I do some sort of cardio for at least 30 minutes, which is either my elliptical, my weightlifting combined with, you know, I do Jillian Michaels stuff because I love Jillian Michaels. Not really well, but I do love it. And I'm like you, I can't do too much, but we try and walk every day after lunch as well. Because getting out in the fresh air for me is just so important.
Super important.
So if we can get in a half an hour, we live on a park. So we do a big loop around and it's, you know, 40 minutes if we do the full loop. And, you know, if I can get that in 3 times a week on top of anything else, and then yoga is my other favorite. So
nice.
Yoga. Yeah, I got to look at yoga. I've never done yoga. Well, I do like a yoga stretching that I have, a routine that I did for a while, but...
Well, I love the hot yoga because it makes you sweat the toxins out.
Nice.
Right?
I got to do that. I've been wanting to do hot yoga forever. So that's it. I'm going to do it.
Okay.
Yay. I'm going to try to do it before our next show next Friday. So Michelle, if you had any advice, one piece of advice for people, what would it be?
When it comes to actually making sure that you have the right energy for your business, I think prioritization on your lifestyle is the most important. So I think we mentioned just earlier, there's only 2 sets of rules in your own business, and that's your client's rules or your rules. And honestly, without your health, you can't even be good to your clients. So prioritizing that even over top of your business, so you can run your business successfully and with good, healthy energy. So if that means that you don't take clients until 10 o'clock because you're busy doing your self-care program, planning your right meals, planning everything, then absolutely you do that. And then that way you have nice, beautiful energy that you can focus on your clients straight on instead of being all over the map and being too tired to actually even open your eyes.
So how would you help me with that? Because honest to God, I really do have a problem. Like I'll do it for a while and I'll say, okay, this is, but then, you know, all this stuff keeps coming at me and I get behind and I get stressed and I just, then I stop because I need to catch up and then it just spirals. And so
I'm going to teach you how to say no.
Oh, good luck. I've been trying.
I like to say I said no. N-O-N. No. Not the French one.
No. Right. We're English and you don't understand it because it's French, right? So.
It's no, but okay, so I know we're joking around, but it's like it's been really, really hard for me. It's a really something I struggle with every day.
So first thing really is and I even do this with my clients, is accountability. So I usually work in periods at a time where we do meet weekly, and it's usually over Zoom meetings and Skype and stuff. So to find out how your week is going and what your struggles are, and then we brainstorm to how you can actually work through that, as well as, of course, saying no and finding a memento. So this is super important, even in the, especially even in the coaching world, something that will remind you on a constant basis what your health goal is, whether it be something on a bracelet, whether it be a picture, something in your wallet, a rock that you have in your pocket that gives you energy, whatever that means for you, that you can have it on you on an every single day basis. So when things start to landslide, you would actually grab this memento, look at it, have it near you so you can constantly remind yourself of what your goal is. You're not wrong, because most people usually they only have a couple of weeks before they find out, oh my gosh, like, you know, they go back to the old lifestyle. So that's why accountability is super, super important. Just having someone who's going to be okay with, oh my God, I messed up, I didn't eat properly this week. Well, let's not beat ourselves up about it. Let's really seriously get off the I suck party wagon. You know, let's just get right off of that, because that's what's going to derail you the entire time. Positive self-talk, you know, we're allowed, again, go with the 80-20. Okay, so can you work the rest of the week 80%? Well, yes, I can. Then there you go.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think it's probably something that it's hard for a lot of entrepreneurs because, and I always admire, like I have Nancy, I have another director, Sherry Agaskov, who also does this. Like she owns a business. She's a director of Two Women Talk. And, you know, she really doesn't start till 10 o'clock because she's got this routine in the morning that she'll do. Like I get up at about 4:30-ish and right away I start working.
Yeah.
And then I stop to feed my kids and, you know, the hour, which today I found out that they watch Bernice the Tow Truck. I was wondering why my son had the dude. It's like, oh my God. Anyway, that's a whole other story. Because, you know, like I do block that time for my kids so that we can, you know, ask those questions. So what have you been doing on the bus this week? And but I also found out this morning that my son and his friend go to the giving birth section of the library so that they can look at private parts. What? And then my daughter, my 12-year-old daughter goes, oh yeah, everybody goes to that section all the time.
You're at that age, aren't they?
Yeah, so, but you gotta, you know, and I, so I'm really good at that because my kids are really important. So, you know, I think it's a mindset is that my health is just as important as my kids. But, and intellectually, I know this, but to stick with it is, hard.
You know, and I think it's so important to, like Michelle says there, is to develop a system. And you're exactly right. The memento, I had not thought of it in that terms, but that's why Fitbits are so popular right now. Because it reminds you, You know, and it reminds you to get off your butt. It reminds you to work out. It's like that accountability and the memento kind of all built into one, because it's a system that works for most people to take them to that next level. Self-care. It was a biggest transition in my life and my business to understand the value of self-care and to actually build it into my day. It took years to get it to the level that it's at. And even now, if I'm traveling or something, I'm going to fail a couple times. But like Michelle says, I then had to learn how to forgive myself for that failure and move forward to, okay, now it's going to work, right? Now I got to do it.
So since you're our system wizard, you know, so what do you mean by a system, like the Fitbit?
Well, any system that works for you. For me, it's, I know that my brain is the sharpest in the morning. So I used to do all my client work first thing in the morning, because that was, you know, what I thought was the optimum. But what I found is that if I don't get up and develop a system, and that's why, you know, the Miracle Morning system worked for me, meditation, you know, affirmations, visualizations, exercise, and reading and journaling, because if I didn't do a system of putting it together and didn't make it a priority, like Michelle says, and didn't do it first thing in the morning, some part of it was going to get missed every day, because life is too busy and we have to put ourselves first.
Absolutely. Yeah. Especially in our society, we live on such a fast pace, fast food, fast this, fast cars, fast this, you know, and really it is to slow down. And I learned this especially in belly dance, is when we're rushing to get to the next move is when we actually make mistakes in our actual choreography. But if we slow down and just think of exactly where we are in this moment, then the dance is perfect. Yep. So you apply that.
I'd be afraid of missing the bus if I slow down too much.
Well, and you know, that's a big thing, is a lot of people have a fear of missing something up, missing the next client, missing the next opportunity, being afraid to say no. But like Michelle says, some of your power comes in actually thinking through and taking that to the next level, right? Is this really the right thing for me to do? Maybe for you, you get up and work for a couple hours because the house needs, you know, is quiet. And then when you take the kids to the bus, your system kicks in.
Yeah.
As long as you find a system and a time that works for you and your lifestyle, that's the most important. And that you keep track of it yourself so that you're keeping yourself on task.
I like that. That's a great, great idea. Well, thank you, Michelle. That's wonderful, wonderful information. Now, if people, do you have any kind of special, or how do people get to learn about you? And do they just go to your website? What do you offer?
Perfect. I have a Facebook group called Making Dash Strides Holistic Nutrition, where I offer lots of good points every week and some motivation every single week. You can find me at the website at www.making-strides.ca. You can message me at michelle@making-strides.ca, or you can even call me. I can add that into our...
Let's put your Facebook group in the comments below. We have your website on there right now, which I'm showing. And let's make it easy for people to find you. Same with you, Nancy. If people are a little worried about, you know, what happened with Facebook and they need a better system to communicate with their clients, you put your website in the link below so that people can find you. And really, I think the theme today really is like, you must have good systems with communicating, and good system for your health.
Absolutely.
And now, thank you very much. Now I'm going to have to go buy a Fitbit. And I'm going to tell Sue it's your fault.
You tell Sue it's my fault.
Okay, so thank you very much, Lynn. And we will talk to you soon.
You betcha. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being on the show.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Now, Nancy, we are we have a great event coming up, and I've actually just signed on board for this event. Kelly Falardo, who just did a TED Talk and has a Goldcast video that's almost at 8 million views. Like, that's craziness.
That's crazy.
So she's going to be sharing her story in Fernie, We are hosting an event in Fernie. It's a Women Talk conference. So we're going to have about 15 stories, some 20 minutes, some 5 minutes. And I am giving you a discount today. The regular price is $97. If you use the code Rise and Grind when you buy your tickets, you're going to be able to come and listen to all these incredible stories for $85. Now, Nancy's going to be doing a talk. We also have Alberta's favorite medium. She's a comedian medium or a medium comedian. Comedian. I really
she
don't know.
She talks only to funny ghosts. Anyhow.
Oh, my God. She is so funny. Like, I'm serious. This woman is hysterical. She came to one of my women talk in Calgary, and I just thought, who the heck is, and then she had the room in stitches the whole time. She's really good. So $85 for a full day of incredible stories, a TED talk person, a comedian medium. I will be doing a story. Nancy will be doing a story. So come and join us in Fernie April 13th. Thank goodness I have my calendar right here. I have a system now. So go buy your tickets. Use the code Rise and Grind, and you will only pay $85 to come and share the day with us.
Can't wait to see you, Nancy.
It will be a fabulous weekend. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. We'll see you next Friday, 9 a.m.